Now guys, to get this wonderful cylinder protection off, wow, you need an Allen socket of, even let's see, 5. There is an Allen bolt over here and over here. Now I'm curious. Oh, easy. Very easy. Oh, back here. This side is his brother. Oh. Almost fell out. Not sure. Oh, on this side, the back side is a longer one. See? And now we take the protection off. Oops. So. Now, we're gonna take the, that's very easy, take it like this, okay, there is a wasp, a dead one, now, plop, guys, we need spark plug socket, 16 mil with a nice extender and something like that, then just an ordinary nano. They are really bad. Oh! Wow. Watch that electrode. Terrible. Hop. Guys, on this side we're gonna do the same. First, we take that wonderful cylinder protection off. Wow, absolute great. With a supersonic rusty bolt. Wow, only BMW get them so rusty. This was a long one. Remember? See? A bolt over here. Was it on the other side? We need an Allen key for that. The one is over here. Gonna have a look. A moment. Yes, almost out. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. Hop hop hop. Yes. There, 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 and there. We got 2 long bolts and a short one. I just checked the other on the other side, the protection, and one bolt was missing. Now we're gonna take this one off, easy. And slide it out over there and apply it like this. Up. Okay. Now we're gonna blow. Close your ears. And your eyes. Sure, this spark plug is as terrible as his brother's. His brother is on the other side. Oh, squeaky noises. Really allergic to that. Yes.
Oh! Watch.
Nah. This boy is gonna watch. Wow, I seldom see them this bad. This is neglected maintenance, absolute. Terrible, guys, terrible. My heart cries. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next thing on the list. Take that cover away, as we have to turn the crankshaft to get it on top dead center to check the valve clearance. Yeah, a lot of two. You need an Allen bit of 4. I use my special ratchet, make a link below. Oh. Hopefully I don't drop it in the oil, but knowing my reputation for that, I'm a legend, dropping things in waste oil, in the waste bin. Yes. Yeah, now I can turn it by hand. One bolt out. Hoppa. The next one is over there. Be sure to wiggle it in. Very good. This one is supersonic loose. Okay. Turn it by hand, up, and then I'm always with my hands in the way, eh? Yeah, my hands and my big head, my huge ears. No, no. I like the color, by the way. It's mauve gray. Looks really good. Now, going to the other side for another bolt. A screw. Bolt screw. Okay. Oh, a lot of stuff falls out. Slide it down and then, oh. Wiggle it a bit, wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Oh my god, look over here. Oh, oh. Okay, oh. Guys, we're gonna place this one underneath this cylinder head as we're going to take this valve cover off. Is that easy? Absolute. All you need is an, let's see, an Allen bit of 6. I have a smaller ratchet. And then, yep. Then, knack. So, knack. Knack. Long time, no loose. Up. Man. Curious what I'm gonna find over here. To be honest, I like to do maintenance on a boxer. Yeah. It's actually an easy bike to do maintenance on. Bit out. Then the last one. Now let's see. Carefully wiggle it a bit. And I'm sure I already hear it. Hop. So. Okay, now let's put that one over there. Now, we're gonna put it to top dead center. Is that easy? Yes. Come on over. Over there is a rubber cap. Have to get that out. That's easy. Hop. Yes. This one. In there now. Okay, hopefully, yes. Now, guys, over there is that hole. Gonna zoom in, so hopefully, you can see the top dead center mark. We're gonna rotate the camshaft clockwise. See, turning it. Careful. OT. There is it. And it should be in the middle. So that's up over there. Gotta feel if the rocker arm's having play. Nope. Then we have to turn it another 360 degrees. Hopefully it's not too damn. Then again. Hop. So, yes. And one more time. So, carefully. Because before you know, it's too far. You can only turn it one way. Never turn your crankshaft backwards. Carefully. Okay. Almost. Carefully. There he comes. Ta-da. In the middle, something like here. Now I'm gonna feel the play, if the rocker arms have play. Yes. Then we go back to the valves. Now, guys, I turned the crankcase, and now both the in and outlet valves, rocker arms have play. And I'm gonna zoom in for you. See? And on this side too. This is minimal, as the exhaust valves, the play is always bigger than the inlet valve. I'm gonna show you. As you can see, on this side, these are the exhaust valves. This is the exhaust, all mechanic. These two are the exhaust valves. And see? Have nice play, zoom in, have fun. We're gonna adjust them. Is that easy? Absolute. Can you do it? You, over there. Yeah, of course. With my video, no problem. To adjust the play, you need an Allen key of 3, a wrench of 10 for the locking nut, and feeler. Gauge. And the outlet valve needs to be at 0.30 mil. Here I got my... We start with 32. And see if we can get it. Yep. So, these are too loose. And this one also. Whoa. Yep. So, then we're gonna take, first we're gonna take 30, see, 30. Then we're gonna loosen this locking nut. Hop, yes. Then we take our Allen key. And now, with the inner one, we can adjust the valve play. This is 30, and it needs to be with a little, wait a minute, a little drag. Go over there, see? And then turn it tighter. Tiny bit more, wait a minute, more, and now, yes, this is the play. See, I need to put a tiny bit of force, a beetje losser, so, this one, that's it. Then, hold your Allen key like this, and get the locking nut. Okay. Then we give it another measurement. Yes. This one is now perfect. And this one was also way too loose. Now, gonna do the same. Hop, loosen that nut, get your Allen key, hop, then bit normally it's put it underneath and then put it a tiny bit up. Okay, yes, that's it. Hold it and use the locking nut to lock it. Up, Yes. Feel it. Yes. That's good. And that's also good. Yep. Perfect. On this side. Then we go to the inlet valves. That's also very easy. Come on over. Now guys. This is the inlet side. These are the throttle bodies. Oh, this is the inlet side. And that needs to be at 0.15. And we're gonna first try one size bigger. 0.16. And let's see if this flies underneath. Yeah, easy. That one. Oh, very easy. Perhaps 17. Oh no, 18. Yes. So these need to be adjusted. Now, very easy. First, loose. No, this one too, just for fun. And then, I take my 16. This one. And give it a go. Yes, 16. So it needs a bit tighter. Now 16 doesn't fit anymore. And my 15 is gone with the wind. Okay, here we got 15. 15 should slide underneath. See? 15 goes under. Oops, that one in place. 15 goes under. And 16 doesn't. Okay, now. That's the one. A bit like that. Then we're gonna do the trick again to see if it's. This doesn't fit. 16. 15 goes with. See? Nice. Now we're gonna do this one. 16. Nope. Fifteen goes perfectly underneath here also. Okay. Then we're gonna carefully exactly hold the unbolt in place, tighten it, give it another go. Sometimes it turns, you know. This is good. Well, job done.